from Oracle Park in San Francisco. Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Arizona Diamondbacks taking on the San Francisco Giants. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about set to go now. Our starting pitcher in this one, Logan Webb.
Great sinker. Although it's not his primary pitch, it's really a pitch that he can go to. Misses the barrel of the bat, gets ground balls, and lets the defense work behind him.
This is Corbin Carroll. One, one down. Big swing and a miss.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Fights that one away. Still one and two. This one lifted in the air. Left field. On the move. And makes the grab. And there's one down. Now the Diamondbacks lineup as put together by Torey Lovello. All right, Singy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Breaking ball through there for a strike. One out, base is empty. Swings and misses, two down.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Hitters become defensive, and all of a sudden that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. Sizing this one up, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for Arizona, and now we'll see what the Giants can do. No score. You're dialed into the show. Back here in San Francisco, and today's starter, Ryne Nelson. What do we have on him?
Well, this guy has the ability to command the game. He's got to limit damage, make his pitches, and avoid that big inning. If he can work around that, he can give a quality start, hand this off to the bullpen later on, and put his team in a position to win a game.
Bottom of the first. Now a chance for Jung-Hoon Lee. Now this is in the air down the line. And that will drop foul. Here comes a pitch. Sneaks through, base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield, so I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed.
Jorge Soler up at the plate. And another ball. And the right-hander deals. That's in for a strike on the outside corner. Two and two. In the air, out towards left center. Carroll moving under it. One away. Here's the Giants lineup. The sluggers in this lineup might not be too happy about the fact that the wind is blowing in today, Chris.
Yeah, and you hear pitchers talk about how good it feels when the wind is at their back. And for hitters, you almost feel like beyond just the pitcher coming at you, you've got this other force coming against you. So important to try to get on top of the ball in terms of hitting line drives, you know, maybe really hard ground balls with a good exit velocity that'll get you a base hit, because it's very frustrating. You just hit one on the screws, think it's going to go out of the ballpark, and an out.
Rudder takes off. Right side, Marte. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
That's a good piece of hitting right there. The job was to move the runner up and give your team a chance to score the go-ahead run. That's exactly what happened. So you better believe your teammates are happy with you after that at bat.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Ground ball right side, Marte. That is the inning. Giants come up empty in the first. On to the second from Oracle Park. And there's no score on the show. Back here at Oracle Park, top of the second. Here's the cleanup hitter for the Diamondbacks, Christian Walker. The 1-1 is fouled off. Right back to him on the mound. Tosses to first and quickly one away in the second.
The designated hitter, Jock Peterson.
And Jock Peterson stands in. Second inning here, no score. And another ball. Next pitch is outside. Eric Summersgill, our plate umpire.
One thing to watch out for, Boog, is what side of the plate Summersgill might be favoring. He usually sets up at an angle. Pitchers sometimes will try to figure that out early so they can attack that spot and get as many strike calls as possible.
And it's fouled away. Payoff pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. One down, base is empty. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The wind of the pitch. And a swing and a miss. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
That is good.
Next to hit for Arizona, Gabriel Moreno. Kicks and fires.
Nope, that's a ball. Two balls, one strike.
Two outs, base is empty. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Conforto on his way over. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is that. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And we're back. And here is Michael Conforto.
No left fielder. Michael Conforto.
And the pitch. And that one fouled off. And a pitch. Line drive to short and caught.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
Mike Yastrzemski up here. Mike Yastrzemski, originally drafted by the Orioles, 14th round out of Vanderbilt in 2013. The Giants got him in March of 2019. And San Francisco's really where he got a shot to play. Fouls that off to the left and will do it again. Another 1-2. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. And a 1-2. Next offering misses down and away. That one 95 to finish him off. Tyrell Estrada to the plate. Strike on the inside corner. Hit. And that extends the inning.
Batting in, the catcher, Patrick.
Now the catcher up to hit, Patrick Bailey. Two outs. Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boog. We knew it wasn't coming back. Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
Nick Ahmed here to hit. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. And that'll fall for a base hit. So now back to the top of the order.
The batter, the center fielder,
Jung Hoon Lee will hit next. The 3-1. He swings and fouls one off.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Got it by him for the K. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Top half of the third inning. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now.
Eugenio Suarez.
Stays alive. The pitch. Got him looked in. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at-bat like that one.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Alec Thomas now, Chapman. Tosses across to first. First two batters retired here in the top of the third.
Batting none. The shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo.
At the plate, Geraldo Perdomo.
He's not the power guy, but he can hurt you to all parts of the ballpark.
Two down, nobody on. And a foul ball. The 1-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Diamondbacks down quickly, and they're down 2-0. And welcome back to the ballpark as we go to the last of the third. And here is Jorge Soler. And a pitch. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Righty delivers. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. The pitch. That's to third. Over to first. So they get the out after a long battle at the plate.
The first baseman, Lamas Wade Jr.
So here's Wade now. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Two and two. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And he deals. Misses off the plate, and the count's full. One down, base is empty. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Under it. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
Now batting, third baseman, Matt.
Two outs, base is empty. Now Matt Chapman at the plate. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does.
And I think that skill set really upgrades the position because when you have that kind of speed, it makes the whole team that much better.
Next pitch is outside. What about him playing another position on defense, one that would require a little more range?
Absolutely, and I think if push came to shove where they had to make a move during a game.
This one's into the outfield, could be extra bases. And he's in at second with a two-out double.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
And it's scoring position with two away. The batter will be Michael Conforto. Man at second. Late with the swing there.
One ball, two strikes.
Left-hand batter waits. Pitches in the dirt. Now 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One left for San Francisco, but they hold a 2-0 lead. As we go to the top of the fourth, here's the center fielder, Corbin Carroll.
Corbin Carroll.
The pitch. And another ball.
Well, these Diamondbacks, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. So many of their outs have come from weak contact on pitches they're chasing outside of the strike zone. You can't do much of anything with those locations, and that's been true again today.
The wind of the pitch. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Now back, second baseman.
An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. On the ground to first, could be two. To second, that's one. Back to first, double play. 3-6-3, nicely done.
For me, that's one of the toughest double plays to turn on the infield. The first baseman has to get inside, create a throwing lane to hit that middle infielder to start the double play, and then from there, completing it back to first. Really good job all the way around.
Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The wide to kick the pitch. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. That completes the strikeout, inning over. Here in San Francisco, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Mike Yastrzemski. Pitches in there. And a count 1-2. The Diamondbacks with some movement in the pen. Bryce Jarvis up and throwing for manager Torey Lovullo. Frias also throwing. And here comes. Hit on the ground to the right side. And that's just foul. And a 1-2 again. That's a little bit low. That just misses. Counts full, 3-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And the righty deals. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to play off some really close pitches, and somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Nobody out, runner at first. Fouled off. He was late. And that's in the dirt.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher. But if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself into scoring position.
Cut on and missed, struck him out, and now one away.
Well, I'm not sure what he was waiting on right there. He got the changeup and still late on it. You rarely see that. It almost makes you think that he was trying to set the pitcher up. I mean, if you can't catch up to the off-speed stuff, there's no way you're going to touch a fastball.
Torrey Lovello is out of the dugout, and he's going to make a move here. Ryne Nelson won't go any further tonight. Just never found his groove, wasn't able to settle in. New arm coming on, back in a moment. Now on the mound for the Diamondbacks, Bryce Jarvis.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
And now here is Patrick Bailey. That misses, and a count 2-1. At the belt and fires.
Ball.
And pitch in for a strike. 3-2 down.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away. If you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for hitters to square that up. That's what you'd love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Dives, and he can't hang on. Now he gets it to the pitcher covering the bag. So a tough play, but they do get out number two.
This is what it's all about on that right side of the diamond when you've got the first baseman involved and the pitcher as well. First baseman does a great job, knocks the ball down, gets away from a little bit, doesn't panic. The pitcher's exactly where he's supposed to be. Nice feed and a nice play for the out.
And up next for San Francisco, Nick Ahmed. And that gets the inside corner for a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
Man on second, two down. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Two outs. Struck him out swinging. Moreno gathers, throws to first in time. So the drop third strike doesn't hurt him, and that's that. No runs, no base hits, no errors, and one left. We're headed to the fifth. It's the Giants 2 and the Diamondbacks nothing. New inning getting started. Now here's the cleanup hitter for Arizona, Christian Walker.
Walker.
Kicks and deals. Swing and a tapper. Gets it to first. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
The batter, number three, designated hitter, John.
Here's Jock Peterson.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
And the right-hander deals. And a foul ball. Up the middle, boots it. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Gabriel Moreno. Right through there for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Righty delivers. And another ball. On the ground right side. And that one finds its way through. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone. And Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. Right-hander kicks, deals. Right back to the mound. Could be an easy two. Ahmed for one. Over to first. That's two. Nicely done. 1-6-3, and that will end the inning. So they've been held scoreless through five. It's the Giants 2 and the Diamondbacks nothing. And we're back. And now the center fielder, Jung-Hoon Lee. Here's some fun facts about Jung-Hoon Lee. You look at the fact that he wears number 51. Not a shocker, but his favorite player growing up, Ichiro Suzuki. Suarez to first. And that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
Number two, designated hitter, Jorge
Soler, the next Giant to hit. One down, base is empty. And another ball.
Good spot there, but didn't get the strike at the knees and doesn't seem too convinced by the call out there on the mound as he tries to get a better sense of the umpire strike zone.
Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Righty to the plate.
Count is 3-2.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Right-handed reliever. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two out.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely up and next, just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Anytime if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. And that one hit to first, and it goes just foul. That one in the dirt, 2-2. Inside, almost got him. Two down, nobody on. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. The wind and the pitch. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. The pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. About to see the 11th pitch of the at-bat here. Bounced up the middle. Giants go in order. Giants go down quietly as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. We go to the top half of inning number six. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Alec Thomas. Kicks and fires. That one almost got him. And that's a little bit high. 3-2 now.
Now in this three ball count, down in the ball game, you've got to be very selective. Take your walk if they'll give it to you.
The other way. Jumps, but it's off his glove. And safe. Bang, bang play, but speed wins on a great effort there.
That's why you run hard 90 feet. Take nothing for granted, especially when you've got great speed. I'll take the infield knock.
Now up next for Arizona, Geraldo Perdomo. Here's a 1-1. Just missed.
I love this part of the game. Does he really want to try and steal second against this catcher? I know he's fast, but it's pretty risky.
Here goes the runner. Pitching for a strike. And that's a stolen base, not even close.
Here's what I think the manager's thinking right now. Today, we're not driving the ball. It's hard to get extra base hits. We've got to make something happen to get a runner into scoring position. That stolen base, excellent call. Now, all it takes is perhaps a single to put a run on the board.
Man at second. High fly ball down the left field line. Conforto brings it in with a nice running grab. Corbin Carroll, the next to hit.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
On the ground to third. Slings to first. Play is made. Two out. Ketel Marte up to the plate. Ziggy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Man on second, two down.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
That one just missing inside. Two balls, two strikes. Swing and a drive, deep right field. Back there. And it ties it up. It's 2-2.
That's a game changer right there. A big time swing, and we're all tied up. That slider on the outside part of the plate is typically hit the other way, but to be able to get to it, pull the baseball, and get it up in the air for a home run, I'm just really impressed.
So two away with nobody on. Here's Gurriel. Two outs. Hot shot to first base, and he snags it to end the inning. D-backs add a pair on the homer. And we're deadlocked now at two apiece. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back here at Oracle Park, bottom of the six. Now it's going to be Matt Chapman. Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss, and it's one and two.
Two strikes.
Gets a piece and stays alive. And another ball.
It's so hard to slow yourself down when you see that juicy breaking ball, but the most success happens when you try to take that right back up the middle approach.
Fly ball down the line. And it jumps the wall in foul territory for an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next hitter to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
Michael Conforto will climb in. And a pitch.
That's a ball.
And a 2-1 hammered but foul. Go-ahead run at second here in the bottom of the sixth. And another ball. Mike Yastrzemski on deck for San Francisco. And a pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Side, and that is ball four.
The right fielder, number five, Mike.
First and second, no outs. Here comes Mike Yastrzemski to the plate. Chapman, the lead runner at second. Conforto on at first with nobody out. That clips the zone, and that is strike two.
He's looking for a strikeout or a ball on the ground for a double play to sort of calm this situation down.
Oh, he hit him. And that got him pretty flush. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch. Here's the second baseman, Tyro Estrada. Base is loaded, nobody out. And that one fouled off.
They need a strikeout, and you need a ball. Perhaps on the ground for a double play or get yourself a pop-up, something, but you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
In the air, left field. Base hit. Long run is in. Here's the throw of the plate. But it's offline. He will score.
Well, he was a little off balance. He got the front foot down, but was so great at keeping the hands back and allowed him still to get good wood to this baseball. Big one there as he drives in a couple of runs.
Now it's the Giants catcher, Patrick Bailey. And a payoff pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Laboring here, about to throw his 30th pitch of the inning. Belt and fires. This one smoked out to left, and he makes the catch.
Now that not your shot, Nick Ahmed.
And digging in for San Francisco, Nick Ahmed.
The bottom of the order here, Boog. You got to go right after this guy
as they look to pick up an add-on run, and the number nine guy at the plate. Two on, one out. Fought off foul. One, two. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. And he deals. Foul ball still, one and two count. Runners at first and second with one gone. That one the other way. And that's a base hit. Coming home. He'll score. It's 5-2.
comes through with the RBI. Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap. And I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Joe Mantiply.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up.
I think it's a good move.
I know I never liked when opposing teams did that to me.
Back to the leadoff spot of the Giants lineup. Now here is Jung-Hoon Lee. Ground ball to the right side. On to first. Out number two, and another one comes in. Jorge Soler, the next Giant to hit. And a pitch. And there's a rocket into the outfield around third. He'll score easily. And the lead is up to five. And that's a two-out double.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
Here's Lamont Wade Jr. And that's off the inside edge. And that's ball two. Left-hand hitter waits. And that one pulled foul. Soler on its second with two down. And another ball. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. But nine batters hit in the inning. Five come around to score. We're through six full. It's the Giants 7 and the Diamondbacks 2. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Dalton Jeffries.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
And now it's Christian Walker.
Christian Walker.
And another ball. Movement in the bullpen. Eric Miller getting ready to come in for Bob Melvin. Number 74 getting cranked up as well. Fouls one off, 2-2.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
The pitch. Out to short, Ahmed. Slings it across, and they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh. And now Jack Peterson. The wind of the pitch. That one's sizzling on its way through to the outfield. So a man aboard now with one away.
Everything came together for him. We've all seen the defensive shift make a big difference in defending against pull hitters, but it's not foolproof. He pulled it as expected, but he found a hole that time.
So, man aboard, Gabriel Moreno, now at the plate. The Giants leading by five here in the top half of inning number seven. Hey, struck him out. Really fooled him with a breaking ball there.
Well, classic pitch sequencing there to change eye levels for the punch out. That fastball on the pitch before was up. It was very competitive, and that gets you thinking that he might try to climb the ladder. But then the curveball out of that same tunnel just falls off the table, and you can't make contact.
Two outs. In the air out to center. Moving under this one. And that is that. One left for Arizona. They're down five. It's 7-2. Bottom of the inning. And here is Matt Chapman. Here's a 1-1. And there's a strike. Activity in the bullpen. Number 27 up and throwing for manager Torey Lovello. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Hit hard on the ground is short. One up, one down.
Well, Lou, we talk about how the ball is coming out of the pitcher's hand. The way it comes out of his hand as an infielder. Wow, really impressive.
Michael Conforto getting ready to hit. On the ground to first, Walker. And he handles it himself for the out.
The right fielder, number 5. Mike Yastrzemski.
Now at the plate, Mike Yastrzemski. Just missed. Two down, nobody on. And now the count is full. And another power hitter lurking in the on-deck circle. Swing and a miss. Curveball in the dirt. In time, the 2-3 strikeout ends the inning. So they make short work of them there. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Giants 7 and the Diamondbacks 2. And welcome back to the ballpark. We go to the eighth, leading off, Alec Thomas. Left-hand batter waits. This to third. Chapman over to first in time. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
Shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo.
Stepping in, Geraldo Perdomo. Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. The shortstop takes the ball. Fights it off, he'll see another.
That was the emergency hack right there.
One down, base is empty. On the ground, right side. Two up, two down. So back to the top of the Arizona lineup. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Corbin Carroll. Two outs. Swing and a high fly ball in the air left field. That's back. and it's into the bleachers, out of here. A shot to the opposite field, and they cut into the lead. It's 7-3.
This game just got a little more interesting with that home run. Man, he just barely got that one out of here, and you've got to love the effort and left to try and bring it back. He had a good shot at it, just couldn't quite pull it off. It would have been a stunner if he did.
Here's Ketel Marte. Two down, nobody on. And they'll do it again.
Come on, guy.
Stays alive. Misses, and it's 3-2. Fly ball near the pole. That one is foul. Three, two. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Three and two. Payoff pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. Payoff pitch. Bounced out to short. Ahmed gets it to first. They get the out on Marte. And that is the inning. But the Diamondbacks do get one back with a homer. It's now a four-run lead at 7-3. Back after this on the show. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Ryan Thompson.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And digging in for San Francisco, Tyro Estrada.
The second baseman, Tyro Estrada.
And here it comes. Good job to fight that one off. And a pitch. Ground ball left side. Suarez throw to first in time. One gone to the bottom of the eighth.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground. Nice ground out.
Patrick Bailey, the next Giant to hit. The 2-1. And there's a foul ball. Here's a 2-2. Tapped softly on the ground. Two up, two down.
Now batting, shortstop, Nick.
And up next for the Giants, Nick Ahmed. Two down, nobody on. Here the bottom half of the eighth inning. Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. That missed inside. Two balls, two strikes. Yeah, the right-hander deals. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Giants are down 1-2-3. But they lead it by four. It's 7-3. Back here in San Francisco, and it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr.
Lourdes Gurriel.
The 2-1. Swing and a miss. And another ball.
Talk about the right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
The wind of the pitch. On the ground to the left. And foul ball. Righty delivers. Left field, way back there. It bangs off the wall. Now he'll turn for second. The relay, not going to get him. He's in there.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
So, man aboard, Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Pitch misses outside. 3-1 now. Runner at second, nobody out. Line to left. Conforto makes the grab. One down.
The batter, number three, designated hitter, John.
So now here's the DH, Jock Peterson. The 1-1. Out there to center. Under this one. Two way down. Diamondbacks down to their final out. Next to hit for Arizona, Gabriel Moreno. Late on that fastball.
One ball. So far, all we've seen in this at bat are fastballs. Look for him to slow it down right here ahead in the count.
The Diamondbacks down to their final strike. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And that'll do it.
Well, I'm not sure if he expected to get 9 outs in this one, but he had the gas in the tank to get it done. Kind of a throwback save for this guy today, but helps the team get the win. As you can see, they're pretty happy about it, and they're celebrating his performance in this one.
7-3 is how this one ends. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. We'll see you soon.
final line score tonight. First for the victorious Giants. 7 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 5 runners